Tonight in Covey Pro Wrestling, we relive a match between Amber Rodriguez and Jessie Belle. We hear from Big Ace Montana and Bazooka Joe after their match from last week was interrupted by Louis G. Rich and A-plus Aken Pembrooke. Covey Pro Wrestling starts right now! Hello Nation, welcome to Covey Pro Wrestling, and Nation, we are less than a month away from the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament. So tonight, we'll take a look at the champions that will be defending the gold during such event. Let's start with Amber Rodriguez, because on August 16th, she'll be defending the women's title against Nyla Rose. Right now, let's see her in action against Jessie Belle.
Introducing first, the challenger, from Pikesville, Kentucky, she is a former Covey Pro Women's Champion, she is Jessie Belle.
Looks It looks like Amber was able to clean up nicely after her little accident early with her pie.
Yeah, and you know there's gonna be some bad blood over that.
And there's our former women's champion, Jessie Belle, showing off that title. A good chance you might be taking it back tonight.
Oxygen going into the lungs for one.
And it's a roll through into a pinning combination, but Amber was able to roll one through it. Good attempted counter from Amber, but here we go over again. Only one.
Now Amber flipping back for the pin attempt.
This is making Amber work even harder, and Jesse's giving her the tour of the ring.
Oh, so not only are you losing breath every time you take one in, as that vice squeezes in a little tighter, now you're dizzy from having rolled around the ring.
Think of a boa constrictor. And now think of a bronco.
Come on. Oh.
Swing out mom into a pin, hooks the leg. Only one.
The women's champ seems to be taking the brunt of the assault right now.
And the women's champion bails to the outside.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? I'm the newest up-and-coming star of Covey Pro Wrestling. Your Saturday Night Delight, Brown Sugar Jones. I ain't always been the nicest guy, so I always depend on my friends, whether Holtz Bonding, to have my back. Now, they're located in Martinsburg, West Virginia, at 306 West Stephens Street. You can also give him a ring there on the phone, 304-267-5888. They offer affordable financing. Tell them Brown Sugar sent you.
Hey everyone, this is your favorite women's champion extraordinaire, Mickey James. And when I am in Williamsport, Maryland, I buy all of my video games, at least the ones I'm in, at Time Warp Media. They buy, sell, and trade all video games, music, and movies, from classic Nintendo to Xbox, from vinyl to Blu-ray. Who knew? They have it all. So be there, and you never know, you might see me.
That's a smart move.
After the offense gets enough foot in order, she needs to catch her breath.
Jessie Belle giving her a chance to catch her breath, but here's the thing, she can't win the belt by a count out, so all Amber's got to do is keep walking around.
Yeah, but Amber better watch her back. Big right hand from Amber Rodriguez. Irish whip reverse, make it two, and Jessie eats the corner post.
Right back in. You're right, she is the ultimate opportunist. The Mariqua Barbie. The Barbie killer. She's got about 1,000 nicknames.
This works to Amber's advantage. As does that arm snap off the second rope. Jessie's well known for that Southern Comfort finish, and it takes both arms to apply it properly.
Well, and you don't think that our women's champ being crafty and being from New York herself is going to realize that that's the way to go? Showing off a little for the crowd?
She may be showing off now, but we know she's done her homework for this match.
I think they enjoyed that show.
Now right back in with the boost in the midsection, right back to work on that left arm. Hammer lock with the knee driven into the shoulder blades. Make it two. And there's a third. Really focusing on the elbow joint and shoulder.
Yeah, she's, like you said, you know, Southern discomfort. If she's not able to, you know, a variation of a gory bond, if she's not able to get that locked in without the use of both arms.
We've seen this before.
We have indeed. It's time for a little bump and grind.
Right into the scissor stomp.
There's nothing wrong with a little bump and grind.
I think Jessie would disagree with you at the moment.
Probably so, but nevertheless, to the hook of the leg.
Only two, not enough yet. But Jessie's left arm is obviously injured, right back into that hammer lock.
As our champ continues to work over the arm.
Focusing her attack on that elbow and shoulder. And there's a knee drop to the elbow, as we said. Make it two. And now they're punching away at the elbow.
Now you can almost see the swelling starting right now. She's done serious damage to that arm.
Amber had an armbar applied, but Jessie fights off. I spoke too soon. Hair takedown from Amber Rodriguez.
What hair takedown? That was a snapback.
Amber going right back to work on that arm.
And see, Jessie tried to reach through to prevent that from happening.
Amber having that arm torqued around her own leg, she was able to drive her knee into the shoulder while working on the elbow. Into a quick pin, both legs up. Only two.
You know the old cliche about living to fight another day?
Double clothesline from Amber and Jessie. Living to fight another day may apply in some situations, but Jessie Belle, the Southern Spitfire, she doesn't give up that quick or that easily.
But the damage that has been done to the arm, that arm has been worked over, and she's still got to be out there on the road. She's still got to make a living.
Bringing that boots in the second, cuts off, fires back with a shot to the jaw. Amber misses and takes a chop to the face. And a big neck takedown. Snapmare takeover. With a drive back kick to the jaw and a double leg drop. Only two.
Just a two count. Jessie seems to be able to, until now, mount some offense.
Jessie broke both with a suplex. Snap suplex with a float over. She's still got her locked in tight. Make it two.
Oh, this could be Trace Amigos. Shades of Eddie Guerrero.
Third time the jerk. Float over into the pin, hooks the leg. Only two. What's that Amber's got on her hand?
Nothing.
Looks like brass nuts to me.
You bet you need glasses.
Schoolboy takedown. All of the weight upon their shoulders.
There you go. Still.
The winner and still Covey Pembrooke, Women's Champion.
This is an example of when bad meets evil. The experience of Jessie Belle lost out to the opportunism of Amber Rodriguez.
What Amber wants, Amber gets. And she's gonna return back to New York with the women's title.
But for how long? How long can this streak go?
I never used these. But I'm fixing to.
And nation, Amber Rodriguez will not be the only person defending a title during the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament. Also, John Boy Justice will be defending the Television Championship. Right now, let's see him in action against CEO.
It is indeed the TV title.
This is a very interesting matchup. John Boy Justice has the edge and experience in big name matches, but CEO has the experience when it comes to the taste of power.
You know, I think CEO's got this. I think he's in better shape for one than No Boy.
CEO trying to take his time and feel this man out, but he can't take too much time. It's a 10-minute time limit in this match.
Oh, you're correct. TV time limit, 10 minutes. That's the way it goes.
Here's the collar and elbow lock up. John Boy pushes CEO back into the corner. Are we going to get a clean break?
A handful of hair.
And a clean break from John Boy Justice. Right back into the collar and elbow tie up.
Oh, this time CEO marching him back.
Is he going to return the favor?
Yeah, clean break.
Five across the eyes. No respect shown at all. And John Boy is not putting up with it. Big shoulder block in the corner. Here comes the Irish whip off the rope. And a hooking clothesline from John Boy Justice. Putting the boost right to CEO.
You can see the welts already.
He did not take kindly to that slap across the face.
Oh!
Nice head chop from John Boy Justice and call for more.
Oh!
So it stinks so bad.
Oh, he's not gonna get him up this early.
John Boy going for the scoop slam. Hip lock takeover from CEO. Nicely done.
Nicely done indeed.
CEO firing in the forearms and the round kicks to the midsection.
That ample midsection of Doughboy Justice, and look at how shiny those boots are. Just 2 minutes into this.
CEO CEO gets right back in on John Moore and starts firing in the knee strikes in the midsection and the shoulder blocks. Here comes the Irish whip.
Oh, he hit with some force.
Oh, overhand. Those sting so bad.
I'm being quiet in hopes we can hear another.
And they'll drain the energy right out of you.
Oh, there we go. Let's even this out a little bit. Oh.
As strange as it sounds, the ones that hurt the worst is the ones you don't hear.
Oh, CEO viciously stomping a hole in the Doughboy.
That's John Boy.
I said Doughboy.
CEO keeping on the attack. We're a little over 3 minutes into this match. And a few more clotheslines like that, and we will have a new TV champion.
I don't think you need a few more like that. I think his hip came off with that one.
Big leg drop into the pin. Fails to hook the leg.
Well, he was kind of going for the leg in a roundabout way. Bit of a coffee pin.
Too arrogant of a pinfall here. Right into a sleeper hold.
It's night-night, John Boy.
A lot of pressure applied to that neck. Cutting off that carotid artery. CEO's got to get his arm hooked in a little tighter around the chin. Those right hands ain't doing John Boy any favors.
They are not. 4 minutes into this, John Boy about to take a nap. I just setting in for the donuts, I think.
John Boy fires back with elbow strikes in the midsection. Backs him into the ropes. Knife it. Make it two. Irish whip from John Boy. And a hooking close up. Hooks the leg.
Just a one.
Not quite enough to take CEO down yet.
CEO is determined. He's going to walk out of here. The new TV champ.
Here comes the rag. All that weight down across the back and neck. And a huge uppercut from John Boy Justice.
Louis G. Rich here. As a former Covey Pro Tag Team Champion, there's nothing I won't do to get my tag title back, which sometimes means things that are outside of the law. But I never worry because I know I can always call Eric S. Black, attorney at law. That's Eric S. Black, attorney at law. 304-258-2931. So remember, when you see the blue, call the black.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
This match is halfway through time-wise.
It's at the five-minute mark at this point. Five
more heading up
for CEO to take this.
Big leg drop off the second rope. Hooks the leg.
Emphasis on the word big.
Only two. You don't see John Boy come off the ropes that much, but when he makes contact, it's all impact.
The proverbial pig's fly goes right there.
Seriously?
Yeah, seriously, I went there.
Both men are down, I'm feeling it. And John's putting in the count, we're up to five.
CEO
firing away with forearm chops and elbow strikes. Working jumper back into the corner. And into a full Nelson.
Full Nelson. Once again, sapping all that energy out.
And a stroke variation.
That was awesome, and that's gotta be it. 6 minutes into it, and CEO is about to be your new TV champion.
Taking a little too much time, in my opinion.
He's setting him up.
We're going for a belly to back. Belly to back suplex with a bridge.
And a bridge.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes.
That is it. He did it. No, no, 6.5 minutes. He's got 10 minutes. He did it. Your new TV champion, CEO.
No, no, no,
no,
no,
no, no.
Oh, come on, the travesty. How can Sean Kelly get away with that? That is disgusting.
Both men's shoulders were down, but at the last second, John Boy got his up, and CEO is not taken kindly to this at all.
CEO was robbed. You do not rob a man like CEO.
Well, right now, CEO's got possession of the title, but it is not his.
Possession is 9/10 of the law, Chris. Argue that with either one of those men.
Right now, CEO may be in possession of the title, but that does not make him champion. Your current and still television champion, John Boy Justice.
Someone, however, that will not be defending the title is Big Ace Montana, because he will be teaming up with Bazooka Joe to enter the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament. That after what happened to them last week. Let's take a look.
To those stairs and breaking up the count. Joe with an effective use of time there.
Going right to work on the knees and that head right across the apron, the hardest part of the ring.
Oh, returning the favor.
Ace returns fire. We're up to seven. and Big Ace Montana and breaking the count. We're heading to no man's land.
The ring's not even containing. You gotta think, these guys are supposed to be friends. Friends don't throw friends in the steel ring post, folks.
Friendship is friendship, business is business. This is the Joe we've needed to see.
Joe means business, but
we've
still have some swagger.
We've needed that vicious Bazooka Joe from that match with Louis G so long ago. We know Ace is going to go there. Bazooka has to be going to go there to have a shot against Big Ace Montana.
Well, we know Ace is going to go there. He went there. He's been there. Now he's viciously going there in front of the fans out in the green seats section. 5 minutes into it, you gotta wonder, friends or no friends, and
but
you're
Joe's
starting
up.
To rethink. Oh!
Big diving, appears to be a European uppercut off the apron.
They almost...
Elbow? Oh, he caught an elbow. My misspoke.
Well, from this vantage point where they're at, and he's introducing Ace's Ace doesn't even know where he's at. He's trying to fight the fans.
Ace almost swung on a fan, and he did swing right back into Big Bazooka Joe's jaw. Joe fired back with a knee lift and breaks the count again.
Someone almost got a lap dance from Ace.
We're heading backstage.
They're going to take out the entranceway.
Smartly, Joe fires Ace right back into the ring. He knows he cannot beat Ace when he has...
What? What? Hey!
Why are they attacking Bazooka Joe?
I have no idea. Aken Pembrooke and LGR just took Joe out. Oh!
And now right to work on our heavyweight champion.
And now they're both... working on Ace, dumping Ace out.
Joe takes the corner post. Ace gets thrown to the outside, and Louis G's calling for the mic.
Oh, the fans.
For too long, Bazooka Joe and Ace Montana have been the top of Covey Pro. Stop it!
Fantastic. Go ahead and let's make that up. Fox's Pizza, 304-258-8000. They do deliver. 304-258-8000. Oh my. Oh my goodness. Let's open that up. Stay here and open that up with me. Oh, that's definitely a pizza for Big John Green. Fox's Pizza is a proud sponsor of Covey Pro Wrestling and a major ticket outlet.
Hello again, you're watching Covey Pro Wrestling Nation. Last week, Big Ace Montana was defending the Covey Pro Heavyweight Championship against Bazooka Joe, but that match was interrupted by Louis G. Rich and by Aken Pembrooke. We were able to talk to Ace Montana and Bazooka Joe, and this is what they had to say.
You know something, Daddy? What you just seen out there is some of the old school wrestling that pro wrestling has been missing for a long, long time, Jack. You got new school Body Jack, and you got the man from the past. Listen, Louis G. Rich and your girlfriend, I don't even know his name, but if I did, I'd probably slap him. The tag team at the Dave Duncan Tournament. Tell them what date it is, Joe.
August 16th. Bazooka Joe, Ace Montana, on the same page like we should be, like we always have been. And I tell you what, Louis G. Rich, you thought you got a beating a couple months ago against me? What do you think's gonna happen this time when we get in the ring? Because we got a purpose. Tell them the purpose, Ace.
It's real simple, Daddy. We're gonna cash the checks and break your sweet little necks and get on down to the local bar and boogie woogie all night long. Let's go do it, Daddy.
And that's some hard candy you can't swallow.
So it's official, Big Ace Montana and Bazooka Joe will be teaming up and entering the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament in hopes to find and destroy the people that ruined their match last week, Louis G. Rich and A+, Aken Pembrooke. But Nation, this will not be the first time that Bazooka Joe is across the ring on tag team action against one of these competitors. Let's go back and relive a match from last year. Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament.
And it looks like the champ is going to start.
I want it. You got him, Louis. Look, Louis has been staying in great shape. He's been hitting the gym hard. Look at that rock hard body of Louis G. Rich. Look at it. There we go. Come on, Louis. Look at that body. Look at the women's scream. Look at the women's scream. They love it. Look, women down here taking pictures of LGR. That's disgusting.
Don't let it get to you, Russell, in the morning. Bazooka Joe and Louis G. Rich, are you still in the ring? Into the lockout? Hard candy threw him away like he was nothing.
He pulled the hair. I saw it.
Pulled the
hair. Yes.
How?
Check the videotape. He pulled the hair.
Please tell me how he could pull the hair.
He pulled the hair. Grabbed it, pulled it.
Back in the locker. Side locker. And Bazooka Joe. Really, Rich, you
know what?
Now, there's some hair pulling.
That wasn't hair pulling. He was pulling from the chin. That was completely legal.
Go around grabbing Twitter from Louis G. Rich.
You are.
Shopping the section. I have a personal about Bazooka Joe.
Come on, Louis.
Driving the shoulder from Bazooka Joe. And Louis G. Rich goes down.
Come on, Louis.
Back in the side headlock, cranking away.
That's a choke, ref. Get in there.
Him cranking away on the side headlock is how you get caught by our ears. Bazooka Joe's headlock.
him up, Joe. Or, yeah. Louis. Yeah. Come on, discombobulated.
Yeah. Let him shoulder block Bazooka Joe. Yeah. And another. Louis Jesus can't see that guy on the block here.
Come on, man. You're better than this, Louis. Louis, you're better than this.
Draw him in the shoulder. Back into the forearm block and twist.
It's the pressure getting loose. She feels the same logic.
Big John, new captain.
Here comes the old Asian. Did you hear the creaking of the bones when he was getting in the ring? I did.
Huge double shoulder block. Only two.
Those poppy noises you're hearing, that's John's bones. That's how old he is.
Forearm block, pressure of Big John Green. He's bringing them forearms to the shoulder of Louis G. Rich.
That was a legal punch to the shoulder. He seriously hurt him.
Louis just cannot get out of the blocks here.
Come on, Louis.
Big John back into the corner. And a slip. Huge fight off the Big John Green.
Louis is not used to this. I mean, I know he was a great tag team champion by himself, by the way, but like he's not used to being in a cohesive tag team because his partner, his last partner was like, you know, sucked, and Louis had to carry him. Been a long time since Louis had to do this tag team thing. Come on, Louis. Get him off the ropes, grab
him in the arm with the ropes, illegal, don't you know?
Get him off the road, Pat.
Tag out to Bazooka Joe. Double Irish whip. Double back elbow. Bazooka off the rope.
Boom!
Grab by clothesline.
Legal double team. I hate to say this, I disagree with you, but Louis could not get out of the box tonight. Come on, Louis.
Try to burn the suplex. And drop the elbow.
Kick out, buddy.
Right back in the armbar. Bazooka Joe and Big John Green have had Louis G. Rich at their mercy at the moment.
Come on, Louis.
Enemy's neck breaker for Bazooka Joe.
You pervert, Joe. Look, just...
Come on, Louis. Yes.
Get the ball out of the box. Come on,
Louis. And tag back to Big John Green. Double Irish whip in the corner.
No, he's gonna kill it. Oh.
Corner splash. Diamond corner splash.
Come on, Louis.
Can Louis say it? Nope, not quite.
Kick out, Louis. Kick out.
Only two.
I can't believe I'm agreeing with you. He did not get out of the box. There we go. Stop, stop. John, give him a break. There we go.
Leverage maneuver. Send a Big John Green head first into the turnbox and finally attack on the top breaker.
Get him, pal. Your next world heavyweight champion right there. But watch, Joe. That's your belt going bye-bye.
Kyle Freeman running in fourth to the beach to the midsection on Big John Green.
Hit it, Kyle. See, Kyle can cash it in the night for all you know.
Don't drop the ball back, but not happening. Just big man.
He can get the pinfall win over Bazooka Joe and cash it in the night. That would be awesome. I'm sick and tired of seeing Joe in the title.
Running kick to the chest of John Green.
Big foot. With one arm. One arm. With one arm. He is tossing that fat old man around with one arm.
He's being very careful with that left arm he has as well as should be. But that just shows the power of Cochrane. He can do this one arm. Good job, Mitchell. Cut off by Kyle Craven with a knee lift and a forearm smash.
Pull him harder.
Hello, Covey Pro Nation. This is Big John Green. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a professional wrestler, a referee, a ring announcer? If you want to get in on the action, come on down. Give us a call at 304-298-2192 or 240-421-1938. Join us at our Covey Pro Dojo for training for you to become a professional. We're located right behind the Earth Dog Cafe on 522 in beautiful downtown Berkeley Springs.
She's won matches she hasn't wrestled yet. She is the most interesting woman in the world.
You know, I don't spend all my time in the square circle. Sometimes I like to relax. And when I do, I prefer Bang Hound Ale, the unpasteurized, unfiltered, unleashed taste suited for the native beast. Bang Hound Ale Works, 1108 Taft Street, Rockville, Maryland.
Kyle Craven has the power. I love it. I love his trunks. I do more down for Kyle's trunks.
What on fire for Kyle Craven?
Yes, because he's a monster. Look at him.
And Big John Green is no small man. Tag that's a little too rich.
That is an understatement. He is no small man. Get Joe. Get Joe. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him, LGR.
Both Louis G and
Kyle Craven
were
randomly
blown, and now Louis G with a blatant choke.
No, it's not a blatant choke. The ref doesn't see anything. It's a pin. Look. One, two.
Only two.
If Pat was paying attention, there would have been a three count.
If Pat had been turning on, he would have seen the blatant choke.
There you go, Louis.
I rank from there. Louis G rich, Irish whip. Spider kick to the chest.
Beautiful leg wire from LGR.
Who's he going in for your channel? Raking the nose.
Getting that extra leverage. That's not illegal. It's not the eyes. There you go. Look, making him smile.
Fisher.
Louis G. Rich bringing a smile to John Green's face every day. Show them how it's done, Lewis. Oh! One more time.
Lewis G digging deep into those eyeballs. Big John Green.
Yeah, John can't see anyways. He's got cataracts. Maybe he might help him.
Tag out the Kyle Craven.
Listen to that shot.
Driving forearm and elbow in the back. Big one of the two. Two big men training forearms.
Yeah, been staying up too much longer, huh?
I think Kyle got the best of that one.
You get it. Look at him. He's a monster.
Smart tag team wrestling. Quick tag team wrestling. Keep him in.
Really? Did you just saw Paul Louis G. Rich a smart tag team wrestler? Everybody knows that. Double knee to the back. I'm not going to say it. LGR did get over that one. Classic Louis G. Rich.
Only two. Took a little too long.
Come on, Louis. You got this, Louis. Come on, Louis. Just drop the elbow. That's it. Here we go.
Champ is feeling that
now. There you go, Louis. You got him. Hook him up. Shut up, you idiot. Come on, Lewis.
Kyle Brinker makes the save, but what did it cost him?
Come on. Hey,
Brad! Six forearm slap in the face of Kyle Brinker from the Bazooka. And now Kyle Brinker is back again. Come on. Kyle Brinker driving shoulders from the Bazooka.
Can we get some referees that know how to get control of things? Please!
Bazooka Joe and Lewis two on the outside. Kyle Craven and Bazooka.
There you go, Lewis. Power of the punch.
Cast shot to the head.
Power of the punch.
I think Joe is out.
Joe is out cold. That's it, your winners.
Kyle nailed it with that cast.
And that's it for me this week. Thank you so much for watching Covey Pro Wrestling, and please remember to visit us on the web at coveypro.com for more information about the Dave Duncan Tag Team Memorial Tournament and so much other stuff. Nation, have a good night.